Hello everyone, welcome to all for lecture series of Naval Architecture for MEO examination. In this lecture series, we are going to cover syllabus of class 1, class 2 and class 4 examination. If you are visiting our YouTube channel first time, please like, share and subscribe. Our YouTube channel is MEO Exam Naval Architecture.
Hello everyone, this is the fifth lecture of the series of Naval Architecture of MEO examination. In the last lecture, we have solved the numerical to find out the center of pressure of the vertical plane. So, in earlier numerical, what we have seen, just a recall of last class, we have seen that we have a vertical wall, it's like a bulkhead only, and only on one side there will be a liquid present. There is only on one side liquid is present. So this is the bulkhead, we can call the bulkhead is a vertical plane. So only on one side of the bulkhead there is a liquid, on the other side there is no liquid present. So what we have done, the calculation of the load acting on the vertical plane because of a liquid present only on one side. And we have done the calculation of finding the load and the center of pressure location. We have done the calculation to find out the load as well as the center of pressure location if the bulkhead is present, if the liquid is present on one side of the bulkhead. So the liquid is present only on one side of the bulkhead, and we have done the calculation of the load as well as the center of pressure location. So in this numerical, we have a vertical plane, and that vertical plane we have one vertical plane, and this vertical plane is a rectangle plane. It will be like this, and this rectangle plane is a dock gate. This is the dock gate, and that is in the rectangular form. The width of this dock gate is a 6 meter, and the depth is 5 meter. Now if you see this dock gate from this side, it will look like only one single line. So this is the same dock gate. Okay, so on both the side you can say the left side and the right side. On the left side there will be we will consider that there is sea water up to the depth of 4 meters. So this is the sea water up to the depth of 4 meters. We will call it as A side, and on the right side we will call it as B side. On the right side again there is one liquid, but the depth of the liquid on the right side or B side is a 3 meter. So we have to do the calculation of finding the load acting on this dog gate because of the sea water which is on the left side and because of the fresh water which is on the right side. And then we have to find out the resultant force acting on this dog gate because of the both the liquids. Then again we have to find out the center of pressure because of the sea water, center of pressure because of the fresh water, and then finally we have to find out the resultant of the center of pressure from the bottom. This is the whole numerical it is. Okay. Now how to proceed for that? Now first of all try to understand the depth of the dog gate is a 5 meter. Depth of the dog gate is a 5 meter. The total depth is a 5 meter. But water on either side is filled up to 3 meter and the 4 meter, not completely up to the top of the dog gate. Okay, so that you have to keep in your mind. Then when you are going to we will do the calculation for the left side first, then we will go for the right side. So how to proceed for that? So we will do the calculation for the right left side first. How to do the calculations? So first of all we will find out the load acting on dog gate from left side. The formula is rho g a h. So rho will be 1025 9.81. area, now you have to take the effective area, not the area of the full dog gate. The full dog gate is like this. The width of the dog gate is a 6 meter and the depth is a 5 meter, but water is not up to the 5 meter, it is up to the 4 meter only. So when you are finding the area, you have to find out the area, means you can say that is the effective area, or you can say the submerged area, that is up to the 4 meter. So the area will be 6 into 4, and h is measured from the free surface. H is measured from the free surface. So in this case, what is h now? H will be measured from here, so it will be half of the 4 meter. So this will be 2 meter. So this will be a h. So you can put here h is a 2 meter. Like this, you have to find out the force acting or the load acting on the dog gate because of the sea water, that will be in a newton. So like this, you have to do the your calculation. Now we will do the center of pressure calculation. Center of pressure from free surface. So what is the general formula? INA by AH plus H. So INA, it is a rectangle. Now you have to find out the moment of inertia of this hatching part only. So it is a rectangle, so formula will be BD cube by 12 divided by area is half into B into depth. Don't take complete depth, up to the 4 meter only. Then H will be 2 meter plus 2. Like this you have to find out the center of pressure that will be in a meter, and that is coming from the free surface, it will come, I think it is a, if you solve this, it will come around 1.33, like this. Okay, that is from the free surface. But I want this value from the bottom. So how to proceed for that? So like this, you have to find out the center of pressure location from the left side. For the left side, same calculation you have to do for the right side. Find out the center of pressure location from the free surface for the right side, and find out the center of pressure location from the bottom. Like this you have to do, and find out the effective center of pressure location. So I will show the answer of this. So you can see here. So on this is the dog gate. This is the dog gate. On the left side you have a sea water, on the right side you have a fresh water, and because of that the center of pressure is coming at this location, center of pressure is coming at this location. Force I will call as a load, I will call as a for load because of the sea water, I will call as F1. Load because of the fresh water, I will call as F2. F1 we are getting from the calculation which we have discussed earlier, that is 482.6 kilonewton. F2 we are getting 265 kilonewton. Then location of the center of pressure from the top, it was a correction, from the top it was at 2.667, but I want the center of pressure from the bottom. So from the top, by using that formula, if you calculate, the center of pressure will come 2.667, but the total depth is 4 meter. 4 minus 2.667, if you do, you will get the value 1.333. so that I will write now. I will call this is the 1.333. like this you are getting here. Then from the right side, the center of pressure location from the bottom is a 1 meter, so this will be 1 meter. Now if you want to find out the resultant load, or you can call as a force acting on a dog gate will be modulus of F1 minus F2. Okay, so that will be 482.6 minus 265. So you do this subtraction, you will get the value, and that value is 217.6 kilonewton. So like this you can do the calculation for the load acting on the dog gate. Now how to do the resultant center of pressure calculation? That will be like this. F1 is 482.6, F2 will be 265, and I am going to take the moment about the bottom. So this distance, this is F1, this distance is 1.33, this is F2, this distance is 1. So I am taking moment resultant, I am taking a moment about this. So that will be coming like this: 482.6 into 1.33 minus 265 into 1 divided by 482.6 minus 265. So like this, if you do the calculation, you will get the center of pressure location from the bottom is 1.74 meter. So like this you can find out the center of pressure location. So this numerical is belongs to the load acting on the vertical plane from the both the side. Earlier numerical we have done the load acting on the vertical plane, that is a bulkhead, the load is only acting on the only on the one side only. But in this case we will have a load acting on the dog gate, that is a vertical plane, from the both the sides. So how to proceed for that, that we have seen. Now we'll move to the next numerical. So in this numerical, a triangular bulkhead. Now till now we have seen a rectangular bulkhead, we have seen trapezoidal bulkhead, now we will see the triangular bulkhead. So bulkhead is a triangular type bulkhead, is 7 meter wide at the top, 7 meter wide at the top, and his vertical depth of 8 meter. Vertical depth is 8 meter. Calculate the load on the bulkhead and the position of the center of pressure. If the bulkhead is flooded with the sea water on one side only. Sea water is on one side only. So how to proceed for that? So now there are two conditions here. The first condition is given. The liquid is up to the top edge of the bulkhead. This is the first condition. And second condition is liquid is above the top edge 4 meter. It may be we have a sounding pipe, and in the sounding pipe the water has entered up to the 4 meter height. So there are two conditions, and for the both the condition we have to find out the load acting on the bulkhead as well as the center of pressure location. Okay, so how to proceed for that? So first of all we will do the, for the condition 1, we will do the calculations. So water is there up to the top edge here. Then how to formula, what is the formula? L is equal to rho g a h. Rho is, now the liquid is sea water, so it will be 1025 9.81. area of the triangular bulkhead is half into base into depth, and what is the centroidal location from the free surface in case of a triangle? It will be always depth by 3 from the bottom of the triangle. From the apex it will be 2d by 3. So here we want h will be d by 3. So what is the h here? Total depth is 8 meter divided by 3. So you can substitute that value here. You will get the value of load acting on the bulkhead. So like this you can find out the load acting on the bulkhead. Now what is the center of pressure formula? INA by AH plus H. So in case of a triangle, what is INA? INA is BD cube by 36. So what is B here? 7, depth is 8. So BD cube by 36. So like this you can find out the value of INA. Area is 1/2, 7 into 8. H will be 8/3. Substitute all the values here, you will get the value of a center of pressure in meter from the free surface. So this is the answer for the sub-question A, or you can say condition A. Now in second case, there will be some sounding pipe here, and the water enters inside the sounding pipe. So now in this case free surface will be this one, which is equal to 0, and this height from the top of the deck is 4 meter. So location of H is going to change, this will be remain same, that will be a d by 3. So total H will be 4 plus d by 3. 4 plus d by 3. This is the only one changes will be there in the whole numerical which we have done earlier. So what was the formula to find the calculation, to do the calculation of the load? Rho g a h. Area will be remain same, that will be 1 by 2 base into height. The base is 7 meter, height is 8 meter. This will be remain same. The only h is going to change, that will be 4 plus d by 3, that is 4 plus 8 by 3. So like this you will get the value of h. So substitute here, you will get the value of a load acting on this bulkhead. This is the way of finding the center of pressure, load acting on the bulkhead. Now what is center of pressure? Same formula, INA by AH plus H. So whatever the calculation we have done for the INA, that will remain same, area will be remain same, only the value of H is going to change. That H will be 4 plus 8 by 3. That you have to substitute, you will get the value of the center of pressure for the condition number B. Like this you have to do the calculations. If you want to see the answer, we will see that also, exact answers. So only I am going to see the show the answers here. So load for the condition A, load acting on the triangular bulkhead is 750.8 kN and the center of pressure location from the top is 4 meter. For the condition B, where the liquid is inside the sounding pipe 4 meter above the top of the bulkhead, that is load is 1.877 MN and center of pressure will be from the free surface, it is 7.2 meter. But if you want the center of pressure from the top of the bulkhead, this is H is equal to 0. Center of pressure is coming from free surface to the location of center of pressure is 7.2. But if I want the value of center of pressure from the top of the bulkhead, it will be 7.2 minus this distance. This distance will be fixed, 4 meter. So 7.2 minus 4, it will be coming 3.2 meter. So in this way, you can do the calculation of the center of pressure as well as a load acting on the bulkhead when you have a bulkhead shape is like a triangular. Okay, I hope everything is clear, and we will end the class today, and we will meet in the next class. Thank you very much.